Thank you very much, our Zono Pastor. We may be seated. God is good. Amen. I'm excited to be here. The Elite 23. I believe this is the place to be. Amen. Amen. If you are here, say amen.
Amen.
If you are not here, say amen. I'm here on behalf of the international office, in the office of the director, and I bring you special greetings from the founder and president of this church, your father, my father, Archbishop Dr. Apostle Ezekiel Andinawangu Kuti, the greatest prophet of all time. He loves us, and his spirit is with us this morning. Is it still morning? Yes, this morning. All the dignitaries have been acknowledged. Allow me just to thank God for the presence of my pastors. We have worked together for a long time in the youth ministry from different dispositions. Baba and Amaya Mserenzo. If you talk to them outside there, they will tell you that here and there God speaks to me. Not all the time, but here and there. I'm excited again to have a Zonal pastor, a good friend of mine, fellow laborer in the field, pastor for me, an e-pastor. He is an e-kind of pastor. You know, today's world, you just don't need to be any other pastor. May I please have more power on the... Thank you very much. Allow me as well to acknowledge our overseers. These are not ordinary overseers, but if you understand the administration of the church, this is where it ends in terms of pastors. The chairman of the pastors steering committee, the transfer chairman, I have to be nice here, might be transferred at the end of the year, you know. So God is good. Amen. I'm here just to talk to you briefly. I'm an evangelist, I'm a teacher of the word. I sometimes prophesy, you know, if God permits, I might get excited. If he doesn't permit, I have some information to give to you. But I'm so, just put a smile on your face. Ah, come on. If you're not demon-possessed, just smile to the person next to you. Unless if you have a demon coming here right now, you just say, come out. Let me get started. Amen. God is good. I came here with my brother. Brother Victor, Elder Victor, please just wave where you are. I realize that, you know, my sweetheart, my bae, Pastor Ether, she's not with me today. She's my bae, come on. You thought you're the only one with a bae. Well, I have the best bae in the whole world. She's at school, she's doing her degree in early childhood development. So I was coming this way via HQ. She's in Africa, Women's University in Africa. I hope if we come, Manelu, we'll be together by God's grace. Thank you very much. Pastor Bumi, if you could pray. Slap your neighbor and say, it's good to be youth. Go on and say, especially in Zayoja, forward in faith. Thank you. I want you to know something, young people, as we share these few minutes that have been given to me, that we are blessed to be in the best of churches. We are blessed to be in the church, not one of these mushrooming assemblies of God, firepower ministries, prophets so and so, but we are blessed to be following a man who is worth following. It's good to see Pastor Gorima here. We come a long way with her. I was like, she didn't tell you anything. This girl was really something, man. She had a youth time. Good to see you. We are in a ministry that is like no other. It is only in Zion Jehovah in faith where you see people being spiritually empowered in the manner that we are seeing today. In other churches, there is nothing called a youth director. It is the founder or the prophet who holds the mic every time. I was talking to the Zona pastor and I said, I hope you gave young people enough time to preach. And he said there was only one who came and, you know, taught. I said, no, maybe on Sunday or some other day. We must have crazy time to have evangelists who pop up from there and begin to preach Jesus. People who are on fire for God. This is not a bishop's conference. This is not an elders and deacons. There must be chaos in the house. There must be some kind of disorderly order. Then we know it's a youth conference. I've got two kids at home, preacher and a teacher. Every time they come into my bedroom, there is disorder. But there will be some kind of order in what they are doing. Young people, we are all about energy. We are there to make an impact. To that conference in MC Do. You must be all excited up here. Be everywhere and do some things for God anyway. The Bible says in 1 Timothy 4, verse 12. That is the NIV version. Don't let anyone look down upon you because you are young, but set an example for all believers in speech, in conduct, in love, in faith, and in purity. I believe they left the last one because they know it's the most difficult one. Is that right? Purity is not easy to achieve. Purity cannot be seen by the external eye. It calls for discernment. This is Paul writing to Timothy. Timothy was a young man who was full of the things of God. If I were to write a letter here to this generation, who would I locate in the midst of all these people that are here? Which young man would I say, let me specifically address this epistle to this particular young man? I would like to believe there were so many young people who had served with Paul. Paul was a pastor of all, but he decides to write to Timothy. Timothy had separated himself. Timothy had made a personal brand of who he was. Young people, we must refuse to be part of the crowd. Especially in a modern day Zimbabwe, where you don't know what the next day will look like. We must be a people that are identified with the Ezekiel brand. I was so excited one day when I went in my office as the human resource director to go and facilitate and resolve a dispute. I sat down the finance committee, the DP and the secretary. After we had talked, someone stood and said, this man has the spirit of our father. This man came with a good spirit. You know, I was so excited. And I said, I want to seek this God of Ezekiel so that wherever I go and I live, people will say, indeed, the spirit of our father was with us. As Elisha was saved when Elijah went to say, indeed, the spirit of Elijah is upon Elisha. We are not here for political business. This is not a rally. Hence, we don't have a slogan. It would be easy to sing, you know, those funny, exciting songs. But we are here for kingdom business. Equipping the young people of today to be the leaders of today and not tomorrow. I was amazed when I came here. I thought the conference was cancelled. You want to know why? Parking is empty. Who told you that young people must not drive? Now, page 20 of this holy and sacred piece of literature which God inspired our father to write. I'm sure you're getting tired of this now, but we will read it until change is inevitable. It reads here, this ministry is not going to come to an end. I'm tempted to say some things here. Our father was raised by God. He was not voted for. Zach was not involved for Zayoja to be established. We didn't need a commissioner of Zach to say, can Zayoja exist or not? But God called our father and put him in a place which has made all of us today.
Number one, fear God and have
personal brand. The Bible says in Psalms 111, verse 10, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom, and all who follow his precepts have good understanding. To him belongs eternal praise. To fear God is to do the right thing when no one can see you. To fear God is to know that wrong and right are there, even outside of the confines of the human eye. Amen, somebody. Amen. I'm on a rush through because I don't intend to take long here. Number two, seek wisdom. And again, God inspired his prophet to write this book, Secret Wisdom in the Time of Difficulty and the Power of Words. It's good to see my mother there, looking like a sister. On page 9, it reads, Proverbs 4, verse 7 says, wisdom is the principal thing. Therefore, get wisdom. With all thy getting, get understanding. The principal thing is that thing without which there is nothing. I'm going somewhere. In school, we studied what is called contract law. Within a contract, there are principal parts of the contract. If they are not there, if they are not abided by, that contract is void or null. Are you getting this? Now, in the context of a young person who is seeking to be like Baba Kuti, wisdom is the principal thing. We are not yet talking about gifting here. We are not yet talking about anointing. Begin with wisdom. I began with seeking gifting. I was very gifted as a young person. I could just point my foot at you and you're on the floor. My pastor knows that. I was the craziest of my generation, but I lacked wisdom. I was unadvisable. I was full of the presence of God. Even if you are a pastor and you are ordinary, you don't really pray, you could feel that something is in this young boy. But there was no wisdom. Blunder after blunder, mistake until I almost died. It's a miracle that I'm here. And it's a double miracle that I'm in divinity direct. Wisdom is critical in life. Are you hearing me, young people? Without wisdom, we ain't going nowhere. Wisdom is needed for business. Wisdom will be needed for marriage. Wisdom will be needed even to be a pastor. There is no pastor without wisdom who can survive in a church like church. Please stop recording with your phones. I want to pour my heart out here. You start recording, I'll be careful. Amen. Can we agree? Do you want to hear my testimony? So stop recording with your phones. Let him record. It's fine. So I can be free to tell you what I did wrong, which you must do right. Oh yes, I forgot to tell you. I did come from heaven. Like the other pastors, all these people are people of God. In the heart of Tidoga Manage. Are you hearing me? I came from somewhere. I know what it is to backslide. I know what it is to be. There is nothing new which you can tell us. If the sun starts going backwards, yes, that would be something new. If the sun makes a U-turn and starts shining from, you know, going back to the east, I would say the world has changed. If you ask Overseer Chabawa, he will tell you there is nothing new that we can tell us. The world has been and will be. Systems come, systems go. But the principal thing is wisdom. I asked my father the other day, Archbishop Kutia, I said, Baba, if I were to ask you for one thing in life which I must have, what is it? You know where my heart was? Anointing. That day I was crazy overseer. I wanted him to say, let the double portion of the spirit of Ezekiel be upon this young man. He didn't say that. He said, Lindsay, go and seek wisdom. Go and get. He said it 7 times. Wisdom, wisdom, wisdom. And after that, because I took my sweet time, I made a few blunders. And the spirit of the Lord said to me, wisdom is the principal thing. Amen. Amen. Number three, take care of your parents. This I don't want to open scripture, but to speak. my heart out. We are tired of young people that dress better than their pastors, that dress better than their bosses at work, but their parents are languishing at home in hunger and poverty. If I were to say hosting team, me and Pastor Mamam Sereto and Pastor Angolima want to drop you, each and every one of you, to your doorstep, you will find someone who say, please drop me here. Then we say, Tashika, they say, no, my house is somewhere down there, but just drop me here. Why? There is a mother and a father or a mining or my guru whom you don't want us to see. Blouse, $3 downtown. Your grandma must have at least a blouse. Could you look at my blouse? Is there a blouse somewhere? A hairdo. Simple. I feel like someone touched this area a little bit. But let me hammer it down the heart. You need to take care of your parents. I take care of my biological mother. I could be excited thinking I am the Archbishop's son and being all over the men of God and forget my mom who gave birth to me. But I don't forget her. 2-3 days ago, she called me and said, I'm not feeling well. She's a BP patient. She said, my tablets, I got the wrong medication. I had to leave the work of God to go and deal with my mother. Because when I'm going to fuck Baba Nigi, we were with my children there, all over the country, burying people. Some of the deaths is because of negligence. We need to be supportive. Maybe you don't have that much money, but that $1 you get for pocket money, buy a loaf of bread one day and come back home carrying something. Especially if you're a young man, that's when you learn to be a father. A father is a provider. Just don't go home empty. It's not allowed, it's a sin. It's not written anyway, but it's a sin. We must discipline people who don't take care of their parents. Say amen if you agree with me. We must have a board that looks after that area. Because as young people, we work Chintiko. We are the pioneers of Chintiko and we will squeeze you until you wake. But working Chintiko, and nothing is happening at home, I don't think we have a full blessing there. So what we do, we work Chintiko, we work missions, we work love offering, but at home, do something. Push your youth neighbor and say, do something for your parents. Tell them, do something for your parents. Every time I go out of the country, I'm a traveler, by the way. I never spent 3 months in Zimbabwe. It's impossible. Because of the call of God and my own vision to go to school, I always bring my mom something. And you know what? When your parents says, God bless you now, that's where the secret of life is. You will live very long. You see, the former president of this country, forget about the political nonsense. He is still alive today. He took care of his mom. That guy is not really a believer. He is not spirit-filled, he doesn't speak in tongues. But he's still alive today because of keeping his mother. Look at our father, the Archbishop. 95 and still going strong. Put him next to overseer Chabawa, you can't tell. Are they of the same age? You know, they can both jump, they can both sing and dance. Taking care of his mom. Now, I know there's some people here who are bitter with their parents. You are not alone. I used to be bitter with my dad. I used to be, because the guy was crazy, he used to drink, he used to just have fun. And I'm like, it's not the father I want to hear. But you know what? He's the first man to tell me that you are going to be a pastor. Coming from the beer hall, he says, the way you are reading the Bible, yeah, you are going to be a pastor. He said, no, I want to be a lawyer. He said, forget it, man. You are going to be a pastor. One of my children must be a pastor. Parents pronounce blessings. You know, when you pass and go pour out the food, this must be so. Makakorona will pass a job which you do by calling, whether you are paid or not, you will still be happy with your job. That is the number one job. Amen, somebody. Take care of your parents. Now we get to the exciting one. Make the right choices. Amen. Make the right choices. 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 You are the sum total of the decisions you make. Successfully. You are the sum total of what you decide. Don't tell us about background. Background is nothing. Be happy to be born. That's the only thing. Even if your parents gave birth to you and died soon after you were born, forget about it. Solomon had those kind of parents. But he rose to be the wisest man who is recorded in the Bible. Solomon had a terrible background. He was the product of an abomination. But he grew to be a wise king. Yes, he got lost here and there. Like everybody has their own issues. The right choices. Decide the right friends. Amen, somebody. Amen. Somebody saying, Pastor, you're talking to leaders. What's all these basics about? Leadership begins with self. If you can't lead yourself, you can't lead anyone. We make you a chairman today, you'll be sitting for Masofa conference every week, coming with a new client. Ah, I think I didn't see clearly, Pastor. Can I try this one? And you say, okay, let's try. After 3 weeks, another pastor comes and pastor. The pastor who was there forced me to like this girl, but I did not really like him. Pastor said, I saw a lot when he was a new pastor at City. We prayed for him. Because others did not sit conference, they engineered their own sofas. Like I'm seeing some people here, leaders. Ah, come on. We just need to be straightforward. If you see that you have a problem in making choices, go to the elders. They will give you wise counsel. Now, I told you I used not to have wisdom. I am no more the same. When my elders tell me things now, I hear them twice. Even if they are wrong, I don't care. I just follow what I have been taught. Yes, with my own understanding, you have to be a little bit knowledgeable. Choose the right friends. There are people that will drive you to hell. There are WhatsApp groups, Facebook connections that you must pull out from. There are Instagram connections and Twitter people whom you must never follow. Are you hearing me? I know I'm speaking to a few people here. And by the way, I'm not judging you. I'm giving you brotherly advice. Oh, we make mistakes because of friends. There is nothing called a friend who is a brother when you are a sister. Not yet, Pastor. Find yourself gone. Do you hear me, brother? Some of these sisters, they are praying, they are advocating so that we change it. Teaching them that they can locate the brothers. And that revolution is taking long. Through association, you can be chosen. I said to Chitubiza, the role of a sister is to be chosen. The role of a brother is to choose. What does the sister do? She just does the right thing. Like that girl there. She's looking at me like, yeah, Pastor, this is it. I think she's chosen. Because when you're not chosen, you should be like, Pastor, Saka Twitter say, seek wisdom. Are you hearing me? Yes. Wisdom is the principal thing. Make the right choice of a business career. The mindset that we are removing from our young people is the mindset of seeking jobs. Be a job creator. With whatever basic knowledge that you have in life, create a stream of income. This church is built on talents. And I've done my research. Most of the people who run businesses, they are not very educated. Your Form 4s, your Standard 6, if you know what Standard 6 means, your average kind of people, and those with the masters are the ones that wait for them. Are you seeing? seeing something there. Now, waiting for someone is good for a start. But as you wait for someone, try and understand how that business is run. Try and understand if you are at okay, you are a deal operator. As you are operating that deal, try and see how the whole system is operating. We want the people that are delivered from the African mindset of seeking a job. Do you know the sad truth? I'm a human resources practitioner. The employer's mindset is to only give you enough to keep you going and coming back to work. There is no employer who will ever empower you to the extent that you will not need that employer. You can be given a car on credit. You have to work to cover that credit. The people who designed Apple, they looked for young people and they knew young people want houses. They want nice cars. So they looked for the most intelligent and they put them in the key positions of productivity. They gave them a car on loan. They gave them a nice house on loan. Now you are bound to this job. You even worship this job. Are you hearing something?
Yes.
Young people, we must be job creators. Have a crazy kind of mind to say, I don't know. Everything starts with a trial. If it fails, do it again. If it fails, do it again. As long as you have a drive and you and your dream is not to marry a wealthy husband, you will make it.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Now, the most critical one, life partner. We have seen leaders in youth who made history and they chose their own life partners. Now, this is a very sensitive subject which I'm about to touch on. Because you know when you touch certain things, you must be, very careful. Because maybe Pastor from you already made a mistake. Maybe the deputy director already made a mistake. You understand? But to us who are yet to decide and to be decided upon, this is where you make it or break it. Even if another party wins, which comes with the Bible in the parliament and preaches Jesus before they govern the land, you will still believe in hell. Someone's like, what is the pastor talking about? Marriage is quintessential to your success. You are the sum total of who you made. You see, Pastor Senator here, my good friend, he is an author, a prolific writer of books. If my sister here was someone who is skeptical, this man could not write anything. For you to be successful, you need a wife who says, go daddy. You know Apostle Paduke, my Paduke. Apostle Paduke is a preacher who preaches slowly. He's my father. I'm free to talk about him. He preaches so slowly. But my Paduke would be saying, amen, daddy, powerful. I'm like, powerful? This is sleepy food. You know apostles, when they talk, they don't jump like us. They will say, God this, God that. And my mother will be saying, amen, daddy, amen, amen. He's got a powerful wife. I started teaching my wife to say, even when I'm saying nonsense, you say powerful. So if she was here, I would jump, 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 jump. Then look at her. If she looks down, then I appear like there's more anointing there. I wanted to say powerful. Now, young people, a certain admirer of mine lost his job. A man I admired for years, articulate, powerful oratory, well educated than Solomon and anyone who's ever lived, lost his own primary job which he had for 37 years because of a wrong wife. It's there in the Guinness Book of Records. Go and search, you'll find it. You can do everything in life, my partner, having been the secretary of the international office. And one day, Baba Mpanga decides, quit that job or quit this marriage. Choose. You are finished. Are you hearing me, girls? Now, I'm seeing some people who are a bit undecided. Don't judge those brothers. Don't judge them. Don't judge those brothers. When I was a youth, there's a girl I liked. No, it's normal to like people. the apostles are here. You need some kind of correction. There's an officer. So I really like this chicken. Damn, she was hot. You could view me, small body design, but if you don't get a person, then let me see you. So I went for my sofa conference for that girl. And you know what she said? She looked at me from top to bottom. She's like, you. You know, she didn't even, my brother is laughing because he knows. I would do anything for this sister, to go to hospital, buy her flowers, do everything. The day I decided to go for my sofa, she said, you think you can, you don't even have a driver's license. And you want to be my husband, never talk to me again. You know what a heartbreak feels like? Anyone has been heartbroken here? Come on, don't act like I'm the only one who's been through this. I know we are here. So this sister now, get the code to the conclusion. So, you all know what happened. I nursed my heartbreak, but something better and greater came. I married the girl who was wanted. When I went for my wife, she was already with someone. Sofa conference done. But when the kingdom of God has arrived, the game changes. Consideration exchanged hands, or is just a sofa conference? They said it's a sofa conference, and I said, I don't think there is any law which forbids me from trying my chance. I went for my own sofa conference, it changed everything, and everyone was like, that's the power of vision. Are you hearing me? Hey, don't attack people who have my sofa conference. You are not a pastor yet. You will regret it. In the most of the older one. I married my wife, God blessed me. And one day I started working hard. I bought a nice car, very nice car. You know that kind of Porsche car where it's only you in Harare? That's a small car, I had nice convertible. So it so happened I was coming out of Bon Marché and I met this sister just by the exit, which is also the entrance. And she was like, hey Lindsay, how are you? I said, oh, how are you? It's Pastor Lindsay now, by the way. You know, we talked a little bit. The husband was there. The guy, he really looked like I'm a snatter, you know. My heart bled, you know. I was like, so you left me for this guy. And you went for this guy. And long story cut short, I got into my car. And before I left, she was like, we were just looking, hey, that's a very nice car. Oh, who has that? I didn't even tell her it was mine. I just pressed my button, the door opened, I went in there. I had the time to check all the rear view mirror. Hear me, brothers. Some of these sisters, you will see them on the rear view. Story, so you understand where I'm coming from. But my life would not have been the same. I could not even be a deputy director today if I had married that Porsche again. I could be a farmer someday. But look where I am. My vision and my mission, they came together. But even with the one I chose, it's not a stroll in the park. A wife can be challenging. Especially if you think you know everything. A husband can be very challenging, especially if you think you are more educated than your husband. What are we talking about? Pray that grace may abound, that you make the right.
Now some of you be like, ah, Ndoro and Zenza, Zenza, you know, business. Are you hearing me? I know. Like, ah, Zenza, you tell yourself, I'm going with my Zenza. So I told them in Chituwiza, close the book out, my son, I'm not going to be a
a horror specialist. You could join a movie house and say,
are not where you are coming from. You are who God says you are. You are going somewhere. The sisters, the brothers, they must all desire to marry or to be married by you because of how you feel about yourself. Somebody in this place, you must have a clear vision of your life, shall we stand? You must have a clear direction to say, Pastor, from today, why are we here in this seminar? To transform your thinking. To transform your thinking. Now, I'm going to do a mass prayer because we don't have much time. But I see a lot of things that have, can I just have a soft keyboard? Soft keyboard. I see a lot of things that have disturbed our lives. Some of us have been heartbroken. Some of us are just hopeless. Maybe you're hoping if your presidential preferred candidate won, the life would be better. And guess what? Zek happened. You are still where you are. You need to believe Jesus. Are you hearing me? If my people who are called by my name shall humble themselves and confess their sins, I will hear them. We stay in the kingdom of God. I want somebody in these few minutes, as you raise your hand, oh, I thank God so much. When the Spirit of the Lord, which moves in the veil of our Father, comes upon us as pastors, when we pray, things happen. Before there was the UK Deeper Life, I was talking to my sister who's in the UK, and I said, I see in my spirit the Archbishop ordaining another bishop in the UK. And she thought Baba had told me something. I was shocked. You know, I jumped when I was sent the picture of overseers for our being ordained. And to prove that it was prophetic, he was not told before. He was just picked from the ground. He had to be robbed later. And you say, we don't see. Oh, you need spectacles. Raise your hands to Jesus. I want to pray for each and every situation that is stumbling your success. I want to pray for each and every situation that is withholding your success. Maybe it's a heartbreak. Get off it. Let that person get out of your life and move on with your life. Maybe it's the background. You say, my parents are like this. Get out of that thinking. And think like Ezekiel, who came from Gaoli. Now he's all over the world. 144 nations and states of the world. Lift your hands to Jesus. Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ, I come before you this afternoon, Lord. We have raised our hands as your children. I pray for each and every one of them that are in situations that are stopping their progress. Pull them out. Pull them out. Pull out those girls who are failing to prophesy, like the daughters of Philip, because of situations in their lives, past experience. I say, come. In the name of Jesus Christ, somebody, you need to forgive yourself and move on with life. I pray, Lord, for breakthroughs. They need breakthroughs in their lives to begin a foundation that is going to give income perpetually unto eternity. I release blessings upon your life in the name of Jesus Christ. I release favor upon your life in the name of Jesus Christ. Total favor from the Lord. May God bless you.